Okay, so I'm going to show you a really quick and easy way to make YouTube thumbnails. And we're going to be using Canva.com, which is something that you're probably familiar with already. But right before we jump into Canva.com, I want to make it clear that we'll be using a successful thumbnail. Not just one that looks all pretty and stuff. Because just because it looks good doesn't mean that it necessarily performed well. But this one in particular, it got a lot of views for how small my channel was at the time. And it was really small, like under 50 subscribers. And this video, to this date now, has a little bit over 1.5 thousand views. Not million, thousand. And it was also not based around any kind of trending topic at the time. So I really think it makes more sense to show you something that works based on actual evidence. But close to the end of this video, I'll talk a little bit more as to what could have possibly caused that increase in views. Because it can be a number of things. But let's get into what you came here for, which is how to make a YouTube thumbnail quickly and easily. Okay, so this is the YouTube thumbnail that we'll be recreating for real estate photography. So in my view, the purpose of the thumbnail is not to tell everybody exactly what the video is about, because then there'll be no need to click the thumbnail, right? So I wanted to spark curiosity, and I did that by having a sample of real estate photography work in the back, which is the house. Yes, there's a text that is bold saying real estate photography with an emphasis on the photography, but it also pointed to the money and a tick, check. And I tried to position the money in front of the garage, you know, like you're driving towards the money, driving into the garage, but I'm not sure if anybody understood that. Also, if I was going to make over this thumbnail, what I would do is blur this background a little bit more, maybe something like this. Hitting edit image, adjust, and going down to blue. Just taking out the focus a little bit off the back to make the front, the text in the front and the stuff here pop a little bit more. I think I might have gotten more views if that was the case, but I was just trying something at the time. I didn't even know the importance of the thumbnail at that point. Or did I? So let's start this one from scratch. Delete. And delete that background. You could do that or just go back to the home screen and create a design and type YouTube thumbnail. So you see, we still have this blank canvas to work with, and what is the correct dimensions for YouTube thumbnail. First, I started with the image. And it's better to use an image that's royalty free. And I sourced that image from, I believe it was Unsplash, or maybe it was Pexels. Yes, it was Pexels. There it is. Oh, there's the next version of it. But let's just go with the original one. So just easily download this, hit free download. Verify that you're not a robot. All the motorcycles. Download and back to Canva, you upload, grab that house photo. There we go, it's uploading. Right, and then just simply click it and stretch it out to the canvas the way that you want it to look best. Now, I don't remember exactly how the other thumbnail looked, but we're going to come do something close to it. And what I'll be doing different this time is blurring the background a little bit so that we have the front, which is the text on the front, to pop. So we go here and we hit blue. Not so much. We don't have to do that much. We can't even make out it's a house. So we'll just take it a little bit. Right, that's good. Next, we want to add the text. So we just come over to text, add a heading, put that right around there. And so we're going to put real estate, real, instead of putting everything inside of here, we want to make sure that we can edit each of the words. But let's first get the exact font and color before we duplicate that to save time. I think what we use was, let's see, what do we have here? I think it was League Gothic L. That might have been it. So let's stretch that out. We can increase the spacing here in the letters. That's too much, right? I think that's about right. And it was white. The white font, big like that. And then we added an effect on it. So we hit effect and we come over to shadow. And we also want to change the color of the shadow effect for it to pop a little bit better. So we come here down to color and choose black. Right, so now that we have that, that really looks good. I think it needed to be a little spaced a little bit better than that. So let's just increase that spacing a little bit more. And now I think we're in a good position to duplicate it. So we hit this button over here, duplicate. And now let's pull this over here and type estate. Fit it all nice over on that side. We can even make it a little bit bigger. And now we can just duplicate this. Pull this down here. We're going to make photography now. Maybe it was smaller. This stuff is spaced out a little bit too much here. Oh yeah, don't think photography was as big because the emphasis was more on the word real estate. and there was also a different design. We wanted it to stand out, so it was also a different color and effect that we had. I believe it was neon. Yes, but it was a, right, it was green. That looks good. That looks close to it. And then we had the graphics below here with the car. Well, where the car would be driving into, but in this case, we would have the money going into the house. So let's click elements and search for money. I think that's it. Well, it looks close to it. We just drop that in the driveway right there. And there was a checkbox. What we could search for, maybe check. This one, that looks good, but I don't think it was that one. No, it wasn't that one. Let's see what else we have here. I want to make sure it's graphics and not video, because it's not a thumbnail video, it's just a thumbnail. This looks like it. Oh, that looks good. There's one more thing. We needed an arrow to point from real estate photography to the money. So let's look for red arrow. It can be this one. Oh, so what we can do is just hit flip, right? And then we can just twist it around to exactly how we want it. Easy as that. Right, I think it's positioned properly here now. What do you think? All you have to do now is hit download, choose the format, JPEG, PNG. I suggest PNG as well. Hit download, and that's that. And to get started creating your thumbnails with Canva as well, feel free to check out the first link in the description below where you can get started today. So the reason that this video performed well could have been based on several factors, or it could have just simply meant this video had all of the information that the viewer wanted to see. Who knows? I don't work for YouTube. But I would say that I believe that the thumbnail spiked some kind of curiosity while still being clear what the video was about, which I'm guessing encouraged people to click it. And if you're interested in finding out about real estate photography and how you could get started with it and make some money, here's the thumbnail right here. Yeah, this one. I'm sure you want to click it. 1,500 people clicked it so far. You don't want to be left out, do you?